Only talk about what you want. Only talk about what you want. Because the universe knows what you want, is queued up to give you what you want, but when you talk about other than what you want, you don't let yourself go there, which makes you feel so like you need to talk about it as it is. Only talk about what you want. You want proof that what you know and what you're doing works. And nothing will tear you up more than to be standing in a moment where you're not seeing the proof. But you've been hearing us telling you for years and years and years and years and years. Mm-hmm. It may be the thing we've spoken more often than all other things, except that law of attraction is the manager of the universe. And that is 99.99% of every creation is completed vibrationally before you see any physical evidence of it. And so it's completed. You've got to trust that it's completed and start talking about it as if it is, instead of looking for the evidence of it, which makes you shout to the boundaries of the universe that it isn't completed when it is. And it's that one flaw that keeps you from getting what you want now, getting what you want now, getting what you want now. Nothing can hold you apart from what you want other than your vibrational stance. That's why there are no injustices anywhere in the universe. So we want to say to you, in a way that you can really hear it, those rascals that look like they've got you pinned to the ground, who seem to be keeping you from things that you want, are actually angels in disguise who are causing you to have greater clarity about what you want. They have been responsible for you putting more stuff in vibrational escrow, and your future experience will be benefited tremendously by them. But you've got to stop holding them as the culprits in your judgment, because holding them as the culprits in your judgment keeps you away from the stuff you deserve, you see. Oh, nothing is more irritating than to, on one hand, know you're deserving, and on the other hand, not go.
That's what I'm saying. It's the gap. It's like, I know I'm a deliberate creator. I totally believe in law of attraction. I know this stuff, you know.
And but, say the but.
And I'm closing the gap to experience.
But you see, that's not what's in your vibration. You're saying what's in your vibration is, and we know we've been telling you to tell it like you want it to be, not like it is, but we want you to begin saying, so I am where I am, and I know this stuff, but I'm not applying it very well.
Okay.
I know this stuff, and sometimes I apply it better than others. That's downstream. Sometimes I don't apply it well at all. That's upstream. Sometimes I apply it better than others. That's downstream. I've come a long way. That's downstream. I have a sense of what I'm doing. That's downstream. Sometimes things happen that just make me crazy. That's still downstream. I don't know what I'm doing wrong. That's upstream. I know what I'm doing wrong. That's downstream. I'm not applying what I know. That's upstream. I can apply what I know. That's downstream. I'm getting better and better at this. That's downstream. It is easier on some subjects than others. That's downstream. Some things are just so big and so wrong that it just makes me crazy. That's upstream. But the fact that I can feel it and that I know I'm doing it is a good sign. That's downstream. I don't have to figure this out all at once. That's downstream. I'm getting better and better at that. That's downstream. I have worked so much magic in my life. That's downstream. This one issue is sort of a big bugaboo in my life experience, but I'm going to get a handle on it. That's downstream. The good news is I really care about this. This is downstream. I haven't figured out exactly how to make this happen, but I will figure it out. That's downstream. I don't always know exactly what to do, but I'm getting better at knowing what to do. That's downstream. In other words, feel what we're talking about.
Yes,
you can tell it like it is in a downstream way. We're not asking you, and we don't want to have ever given you the impression that everything that you say must be over here in this place of knowing. It has to just be downstream from where you are.
Yeah.
And on some subjects, you can easily go downstream, and on some subjects, it's easier for you to go upstream. We just want you to be aware when you're doing upstream and when you're doing downstream. Esther said to Jerry, and really meant it, Jerry said, that sounds like it's upstream. And Esther said, not from where I am.
Mm-hmm.
That was a downstream statement. And then she said, and anyway, it's none of your business. And then she turned upstream. And then she said, but I appreciate you pointing that out to me. And then she turned downstream. And then she said, and I wish I was as perfect as you. And then she turned upstream. And then she said, you are really good at this. And then she turned downstream. And then she said, and I am sometimes too, and then she turned downstream. And then she said, I'm embarrassing myself because I'm not doing what I know to do, and then she turned upstream. And then she said, but I am where I am, and then she turned downstream. And then she says, I'm figuring it out, and then she turned downstream. And then she said, and Abraham or nobody else has ever been holding me to the standard that I always have to be turned downstream. I get to sift through the data too. I get to have experiences too. I get to give birth to more desires too. I get the benefit of all of this contrast too. I love having an experience where something happens that that makes me clarify and focus and think about what I want in a very powerful way. I love that life is giving that to me now. At this stage of life, who would know that something so big could happen that would cause me to actually begin to focus in a powerful way? I can see that I was getting sort of lackadaisical in my focus, and it's nice that something has happened that has given me a reason to focus in a way that's got me really, really wanting something that I'm really, really not getting. And I can really, really feel this because it's really, really important to me, because it's a really, really big aspect in my life. And because it's such a big aspect in my life, I can tell when I'm focused downstream and when I'm focused upstream, like nothing before that's ever happened in my life. And aren't I grateful to have an experience like that? Isn't it nice to have something that's so big and vivid? Aren't I glad that it's not limp? Aren't I glad that I'm not wondering, wonder if that thought was upstream or downstream? Isn't it nice that it hits me in the gut? It's very clear whether it's upstream or whether it's downstream. And isn't it nice that I have guidance within me? And isn't it nice that now I have given birth to something that is so much bigger than anything that I would have ever given birth to before? And now this very big thing that I've given birth to is over there, and it's calling me, and all the resources of all the universe are over there where what I want is, calling me toward it. No competition about it. It's just, Esther, come this way, Esther, come this way, Esther, come this way. You can't get it wrong, and you can't get it done. It's time to stop making such a big hairy deal about all of this and just go with the flow, with the thoughts that feel good. Just reach for thoughts that feel good, and don't try to use this or anything else in your life to prove anything to anyone. Just show yourself that you can feel good, because feeling good is what is natural to you. And then just receive the natural consequences of consistently feeling good about the majority of things that you are thinking about. And if you should catch yourself in the act, stumbling over something, thinking about something that's upstream, and if somebody else, smart alecks that they're all around you, point out that you're upstream, just say, I might very well be upstream, but I am aware what's upstream and downstream, and I am mostly on a downstream bent, and I am doing my best to get downstream on most subjects as much as I can, and I'm doing really well, and look at how my life is turning out, and hasn't this been fun, and isn't this one wild ride that I am having? Isn't it fun? Wouldn't I rather be on a river that's really flowing and be a little out of control than be in a stagnant pond? Isn't it nice that my river is flowing, you see? Yeah. So you're doing just fine, and you'll look back at this after you get down the stream a little ways, and you'll wonder what all this angst was about. But we don't want to ever give you the impression that the fact that you're in the middle of a sort of tug of war makes you wrong. It's just part of the processing of life. We're just wanting you to relax and take the pressure off yourself sooner than later, you see. Nobody else is going to take the pressure off of you. Nobody else is going to adjust their behavior just so that you can feel good. Even though by many standards it might be the right thing to do, they're not in this for you. Mm-hmm. They're in this for them, you see. Good.
Wow. Okay. Thank you. Thank you so much.
So how about that? Isn't it nice to know that you are invincible and that you're in competition with no one? And that the only factors that you ever need to factor in is where you are in relationship with who you really are. And isn't it nice to know that every negative emotion that you ever have, no matter how strong or slight it is because you're, for whatever reason, not letting you be who you really are? Don't you love knowing that? And don't you love knowing that the you that you really are, that you're not letting yourself be, is not standing in judgment of you? Ooh, think about that. So, let me see, Abraham, did I hear that right? So life caused me to become more, and the larger part of me has already become it, and is lovingly calling me home toward it, and I'm not going because I'm stubborn, and I got other things on my mind, and because I've been telling this story this way for a long time, and it's hard to let go of it, and it's entertaining, too. And you're saying that the larger part of me is not upset with me with not coming? And we say, no. And when you feel that way, you will have made peace with who you are, and then you'll go. That was big.